Hi, I'm Oded Wertheim, the CTO of Orbs, and I'm here to talk today about blockchain virtualization. So what is virtualization? Virtualization is the separation of the application resources from the physical underlying ones. In our case, the infrastructure. Virtualization is not a new concept. It's been in researches from the early 60s, and about 20 years ago, server virtualizations became a common practice. So let's see for a minute what is server virtualization. So we have the servers. And on each server, we have applications that are running. In our case, the red application. And the green application. Now, these applications don't need to have a dedicated infrastructure for each one of them, a dedicated server. They can share a server, but still we want them to be isolated and run independently. While the different applications run on a shared server and on multiple servers, each one of them have the look and feel as if they're running on a dedicated server. And that's an important concept for us. Now, once server virtualization became a common practice, we encountered a new problem, the network. While the servers were virtualized, the network remained common. And every time you wanted to make a change, or for example, for the application to control who uses it, or for the network operator to make a change, they had to impact each other. This drove to the development of network virtualization, where basically now our applications can feel as if they're connected by a dedicated network, but they share an infrastructure. Each application can control who accesses the network and the quality of service or prioritization of the traffic, but they're not aware of each other and they're not aware of the way the network itself is built. This creates a level of partitioning that is very healthy and allows flexibility. When the technology became mature, a process of transition of applications to the cloud became a common practice. And now a company that develops an application or a service, even a very large ones, don't need to own their own servers or their own data centers, but they can use the infrastructure of a company that its expertise is to build such and maintain such infrastructures. For example, AWS, Azure, and many others. This allows companies to focus on their strengths. If you're an application company, focus on that, not on building an infrastructure. It also allowed the companies the flexibility, because if everyone needs to hold their own resources, it's very expensive and complex to scale. But once they share a common one, flexibility to scale becomes a much easier problem. And most importantly, this still kept them managing their own servers and their own network as if they're running them in on-prem. They don't need to worry about conflicts with other applications, and they can manage or govern their application resources independently. With the popularity of virtualization technology, it's only natural that now we'll also virtualize the blockchain. So what is blockchain virtualization? Blockchain virtualization, such as the one running on top of the Orbs platform, provides every application the look and feel of a dedicated infrastructure. Each application feels as if it's running on its own blockchain. However, the applications run on a shared infrastructure with the benefits of the scale and the security of the large network. So let's see how blockchain has evolved over time. Initially, we had one application per infrastructure. For example, in Bitcoin. So we had the infrastructure and the application or business logic, in our case, the token, and the resources that it's used, such as the compute, the storage, and the consensus. Next, we understood that multiple applications can share the same infrastructure. So we had an infrastructure with its resources and multiple applications running on top of it, such as in Ethereum. So we can have one application, the green one, and the red application. And this made a lot of sense because now we don't need every application to develop its own infrastructure, and they can focus on their strengths, on the utility. On the other end, we started to see problems. Applications share the same scarce resources and now had to compete with them. And when a new application was added, let's say the blue application, the green and the red application had to share the resources with that application. This created a problem to predict what will be your performance or how your application will behave. Next, we have the blockchain virtualization. So now we still have a shared infrastructure and we have the applications running off top of it, the blue application, the red application, and the green application. However, they don't need to compete on the same resources. Each application can see its own virtualized resources and it feels as if these resources are dedicated to the application. So if you look from the outside, you see one infrastructure. But if you look from the application perspective, it feels as if you have your own blockchain. One of the main advantages of blockchain virtualization is the ability to isolate each virtual chain. So let's see, why do we need isolation? I think that we all are familiar with the DAO bug and the impact it had on Ethereum, leading eventually to the hard fork and the split in the community and the birth of Ethereum Classic. Now, one way to handle such cases is perhaps to think that there will be no bugs. However, every developer knows that bugs occur, and it's better to be prepared and to isolate your problem as much as you can in order to minimize the impact on the other applications. Moreover, when a bug occurs and you need to make a decision, there's a question: who should take this decision? Should the party that is not involved, not aware, and doesn't hold any stake in the application be part of the governance decision? So the next thing that we need to isolate is the governance. Isolation of virtual chains is not only in governance, it's also in performance. When we evaluate a blockchain, a typical question is, what's the transaction rate or what's the performance of the blockchain? However, what the applications really care about is what are the resources or what is the performance that the application will see. By allowing virtual chains to run in parallel with resources allocated to each one of them, we basically allow each one of them to enjoy the performance as if it runs independently. More importantly, this performance is now predictable because each virtual chain runs independently, not impacted by the other virtual chains. You can even test your performance in QA, like any developer does, and know that after a while, even if many other applications have joined the networks, you will still have the same level of performance. One way to look at it, as if we have a road. And on the road, we don't really care what's the overall capacity of the road. What we care about is what's the capacity of the lane that we're using. And different applications, or as we know, different roads, need different capacity. So one can have a lower capacity, while other, when needed, can provision a higher one. What's important that for the driver that drives on this road, the bandwidth of the road or its, the number of lanes it has is not impacted by the other roads. So what do we have in Orbs? The Orbs platform supports thousands of virtual chains. allowing every decentralized application to run on its own virtual chain. Every virtual chain can determine its own governance model and even its own consensus flavor, allowing autonomous governance for each virtual chain. The performance on each virtual chain is isolated from the other chains and from congestion on other chains, thus providing a reliable and predictable performance.